In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up the gateways that are native to the Salesforce billing application. In the video before this one in this series, I begged you to stop taking paper checks. I said it a few times. Please stop the madness. Missed it? No worries. We put a link in the description for you so you can check it out. And now that you've realized that paper checks are bad, you might be asking, if we shouldn't use those old paper checks, then what exactly should we be using? And the simple answer is that you should be using digital payments. Now, as a Salesforce billing customer, you have quite a few options to take digital payments. And in this video, we're only going to be talking about the ones that are native to the Salesforce billing system. Before we jump into the connectors, just a quick note on a very important digital payment method. Your organization should be considering a move to electronic bank draft payments.
We have made a special checklist just for you on the 10 ways to make Salesforce payments safe, easy, and profitable. So check that out in the link below.
These systems are ACH here in the US, EFT up in Canada, SEPA in Europe, and then direct debit in Australia and in the UK. Systems like these, they exist globally in almost every country. And these systems allow your organization to take very large payments, literally up to millions of dollars, for very small fees and do it all digitally. Sometimes these can be low as a dollar per transaction. Again, check out the description to get a bit more information on these things. Okay, now that we know that electronic bank transfers should be part of your quiver, let's talk about card payments. Let's dive into the pros and cons, as well as show you how to use the native connectors that come with Salesforce billing. When I say out of the box or native gateway connectors, I'm talking about the four e-commerce gateways that Salesforce Billing supports as part of their platform offering. Now you might be saying, hey, you know what? I've been a Salesforce customer for a long time and you don't often see them do integrations. You'd be absolutely right. So why do these even exist? Where did they come from? Well, you may know that Salesforce Billing, it was originally a product called Invoice-it. Invoice-it was based in the UK and the company was bought by another company called Steelbrick. This was back in 2015. So not much longer after that, Steelbrick in turn, they were bought by Salesforce. Then in 2019, after investing significantly in this product, Salesforce released it again as what we now know as Salesforce Billing. And since Invoice-it had implemented four of the most popular gateways globally, Salesforce simply kept those integrations. Those four gateways are Authorize.net and CyberSource. You may know that both of those, they're owned by Visa. And then there is First Data's PayEasy, which is pretty popular here in the US. And then of course an old standby, which is currently owned and operated by PayPal, called PayFlow Pro. Again, those four are Auth.net, CyberSource, PayEasy, and PayFlow Pro. In the description of this video, you'll also find links to all of these gateways. If you're going to use one of these four gateways, then there are just a few quick steps that you need to do. And this is how to use them. First, get your authentication credentials for the gateway. Then add the remote site settings for the payment gateway and also create the custom settings. Next, add a payment gateway record inside of the Salesforce billing setup. And finally, run a test transaction. That's it, you're off to the races. Once you've done the simple setup for these out of the box gateways, all of the payment user interfaces inside of Salesforce billing are gonna be ready for you to use. So how do I log payments, you might be thinking. Well, if you're using all of the built-in functions inside of Salesforce billing, they've already taken care of it for you. There's nothing else you need to do. It doesn't matter which payment functions that you're using. If you're using Payment Center or Payment Sites, hosted card payments, or maybe just doing payment runs, issuing credits, or applying refunds, it's all integrated and ready for you to use out of the box. It is really quite simple. Whichever payment feature you use, the system will automatically create the payment and the payment allocation records. These records, they manage the business of saying how much was paid and to which invoice it belongs. How to use the out-of-the-box payment gateways with Salesforce billing if you need to use a gateway that is not one of the four that we mentioned. That's where Chargent comes in. We have written our gateway connector to enable you to use our 30-plus gateway integrations. And in the next video in this series, we're going to be talking about how to use the Chargent gateway connector.
In this video, you're going to learn how the Chargent Gateways connector enriches Salesforce billing and CPQ. If you're familiar with Salesforce's billing and CPQ products, you might be thinking to yourself, Wait, isn't Chargent a billing application? And doesn't that make them a competitor to Salesforce Billing? That's a fair question. And the simple answer is no. In fact, we've worked closely with the Salesforce product team to build our Gateways Connector as a complementary product, one that expands the capabilities of Salesforce Billing and CPQ. Let's talk about how the Chargent Gateways Connector fits into the billing and CPQ context. Salesforce's billing and CPQ products support things like guided selling, product configurator, pricing and quote management, orders and renewals, and invoicing. Salesforce and Chargent both provide payment automation. You can leverage either of these approaches in your org, depending on what best fits your business. We at Chargent are impressed by how gracefully Salesforce's products handle these tasks. And we built our Gateways Connector to expand that functionality with a focus on what we do best, payment processing. You can use our Gateways Connector to add the following functionality: subscription payments, retail payments, point of sale POS transactions, and direct integration with our list of over 30 payment gateways. With our Gateways Connector, Salesforce can accommodate more use cases, offer more flexibility, and leverage our large list of the most popular gateways used globally. And our list of gateway integrations is always growing, so we're ready for your expansions into new markets. Setting up our Gateways Connector is a breeze and can be done in a matter of minutes. Using it is easy too, as you'll be taking payments directly from the Salesforce billing pages that you and your team are already working in. There's no costly developer to get it up and running, and no costly retraining to get your team up to speed. We're excited to join forces with Salesforce to enrich their billing and CPQ products with our Chargent Gateways Connector. Reach out to us today to learn more or to set up your free 30-day trial.
In this video, you're going to learn how to set up any of the four e-commerce gateways that Salesforce Billing supports as part of their platform offering. These are also referred to as out-of-the-box or native gateway connectors, and they include Authorize.net, Cybersource, PayEasy, and PayFlow Pro. My name is Stacy, and I'm from Chargent. Do you want to learn more about Salesforce and payments? If so, we have made a special checklist for you on 10 ways to make Salesforce payments safe, easy, and profitable. Get the link in the description below. Now you might be saying, hey, you know what? I've been a Salesforce customer for a long time and you don't often see them do integrations. You'd be absolutely right. Integrations are unusual with Salesforce, but they do exist and I'm going to show you how they work. So why do this? First, your organization should be considering a move to electronic bank draft payments. In our digital world, paper checks are frankly just problematic in a lot of ways. They take more time for you to get paid, they cost more to produce, and it's harder to track down mistakes by you or your customer. Second, Salesforce gives you a lot of options for taking digital payments. Before you begin, know this. Electronic bank draft payments enable your organization to take payments up to millions of dollars for very small fees. These go by different names in different countries. In the United States, it's ACH. In Canada, it's EFT. In Europe, it's SEPA. And in the UK and Australia, it's direct debit. Salesforce Billing was originally a product called InvoiceIt. InvoiceIt was based in the UK and the company was bought by another company called Steelbrick in 2015. Then in 2019, Steelbrick was bought by Salesforce, which put some investment into the product and released it as Salesforce Billing. Since InvoiceIt had implemented four of the most popular e-commerce gateways globally, Salesforce continued to support that part of their platform offering. These four gateways are Authorize.net, which is owned by Visa, Cybersource, which is also owned by Visa, PayEasy from First Data, this one is pretty popular in the United States, and PayFlow Pro, the old standby that's owned by PayPal. Each of these gateways are integrated and ready for you to use out of the box, regardless of whether you're using payment center or payment sites, hosted card payments, or maybe just doing payment runs, history credits, or applying refunds. Whichever payment feature you use, the system will automatically create the payment and the payment allocation records. Here's how to use these gateways. The steps are the same for each to get started. Here are the steps. Step one, get your authentication credentials for the gateway. Step two, add the remote site settings for the payment gateway and also create the custom settings. Step three, add a payment gateway record inside of the Salesforce billing setup. Step four, run a test transaction. Now the payment user interfaces inside of Salesforce Billing are going to be ready for you to use. Step 5, log payments. If you're using all of the built-in functions inside of Salesforce Billing, they've already taken care of payment logging for you. There's nothing else you need to do. Step 6, use other payment gateways with Salesforce. If you need to use a gateway that is not one of the four that we have mentioned, you can use our Chargent Gateway Connector, which enables you to use 30 plus gateways. And check out this next video where I'll show you how to use the Chargent Gateway Connector. My name is Stacy from Chargent, and we're dedicated to helping aspiring Salesforce payments geeks like you be a superstar for your organization. At Chargent, we're always here to help. So click on that next video, and I'll see you there.